8 billion years ago, an orange dwarf, around 0.8 times the mass of our sun, started forming 30,000 light-years away from the 2 billion solar masses supermassive black hole at the center of its galaxy. 50 million years later, a planet 97 million kilometers away from the star, around 1.1 times the mass of Earth, began to coalesce, being just at the edge of its star's habitable zone.
During this time, the planet was bombarded with numerous amounts of asteroids and comets that came as a result of the system's formation. As time passed, their numbers started decreasing further and further.
The destruction brought upon by these asteroids and comets also brought something else: water. Lots and lots of water. Organic compounds made possible by the element carbon, after some unknown process, started forming very basic life forms that became single-celled organisms. These organisms began competing over the planet's resources, eventually becoming multicellular organisms. Then things started to get weird. Creatures of all kinds and sizes evolved, constantly trying to survive, until, ultimately, almost 2 billion years later, a species rose to the absolute top of the food chain as they became self-aware and intelligent.
In a matter of 5 million years after this species appeared, they've completely taken over the planet and have developed technology that allows them to generate energy the same way their star and all other stars in the universe generate energy. The conversion of mass to energy by the fusion of two atoms together, nuclear fusion. Using that energy source, this species discovered a way to create exotic matter, allowing for the development of spaceships that are able to utilize warp drive, traveling 1,000 times faster than the speed of light by having space expand and contract within a bubble. After colonizing every rocky planet and moon in their solar system, this species decided to expand to other solar systems using this new warp drive technology that they have developed.
Each ship took around 10 years after arriving to new solar systems to settle, start using planetary resources, build, and then send more ships to further solar systems. In a matter of 500 years, this species has expanded to almost all of their galaxy's solar systems, with several of their ships more than halfway to their nearest major galaxy. In 1 million years, they've taken over more than 2 million major galaxies. And in the 3.8 billion years since they've began expanding, they should have been able to cover almost all suitable solar systems within a volume that exceeds our current observable universe by more than 600,000 times.
If such a species actually existed in the history of our universe, then this presents a number of interesting questions. Most notably, where are they, and why have we not found any evidence of their existence?
What you've just seen is related to something called the Fermi paradox. The lack of evidence that we have right now for the existence of alien civilizations compared to the seemingly very high probability that they should, in fact, actually exist is just something that does not line up. Why did we not find any evidence for the existence of an alien civilization similar to the one that I've described in the beginning part of this video? You're telling me that in the history of our universe, not a single alien species managed to discover something like warp drive, allowing them to potentially expand every single suitable solar system within our current observable universe, and in a volume much bigger than that? Maybe. One of the potential reasons is the fact that our current understanding of the laws of physics tells us faster than light travel is impossible. Even methods that still allow you to technically travel faster than light, you're not really going faster than light, you're just using shortcuts in the fabric of space-time, such as warp drive and wormholes, Those don't seem to be possible to create at this point in time either. But even if that's the case, the Fermi paradox still stands. Just take a look at our own Milky Way galaxy. If any intelligent species arose within it in any of the 200 billion solar systems, and that alien species discovered a method of propulsion that allowed it to go at, let's say, 1% the speed of light, then in a matter of tens of millions of years, they should have been able to expand every single suitable solar system in the galaxy. But no evidence. What is going on? There's an equation called the Drake equation, which attempts to estimate the number of active communicative extraterrestrial civilizations in the Milky Way galaxy. It takes into account the number of stars and their rate of formation, how many of those stars have planets orbiting them, how many of those planets are capable of supporting life, how many of those actually go on to develop life, how much of that life becomes intelligent life, how much of that intelligent life becomes technologically developed, and how long it's been since they've been sending out detectable signals in space. For the first parameters, you can kind of get a ballpark figure, but as you go deeper and deeper, uncertainty becomes a very big problem. For example, our Milky Way galaxy, based on mass calculations, is estimated to have between 100 billion and 400 billion stars. And because of the Kepler Observatory, which was launched in 2009, we know that planets orbiting their stars is the rule, not the exception. So on average, there should be at least one planet per star. And it is estimated that almost as much as one-fifth of those could be Earth-sized planets orbiting their stars' habitable zone. So if we take the mid-range figure of the estimated number of stars in our galaxy, 200 billion, then there should be 40 billion Earth-sized planets, as much as 40 billion Earth-sized planets. And 12 billion of those are estimated to be ones that are orbiting stars similar to our sun. Beyond this point, it becomes very difficult to really say how many of those planets will have life on them, and subsequently, how much of that is complex life, how much of that is intelligent life, and how much of that is technologically developed. We have only had one observation for such a thing happening, and that is right here on Earth. There hasn't really been any solid evidence since then. If we find life, for example, on the water that was found recently by NASA on Mars, or on Europa, or any other place in our solar system, then we can say, hold on a minute, life does actually seem to be common in the universe. And if we get to that point, then the Fermi paradox will be even more perplexing than before. Why? Because right now, where we don't know whether life is common in the universe or not, the reasons for why we haven't came across evidence of alien life yet seem likely to be on this side here, than on this side. It still might be here, but it doesn't seem as likely as they seem to be abundant enough. So let's remove this part right here and begin with life. The first thing we're presented with is the fact that life may actually be very rare in the universe. The very first basic forms of life, which formed around 4 billion years ago here on Earth, it's still a mystery to how exactly they came to be. There are still questions that need definitive answers when it comes to their chemistry, how exactly they became more than what they are, and so on and so forth. And before we get answers to those questions, it becomes difficult to really say, well, life is common in the universe. But let's say that we do find evidence that life is common in the universe. Maybe what's so rare are complex forms of life. Here on Earth, over the past few hundred million years, you could say we've been relatively stable. Sure, there has been the mass extinction event here and there, but we've been okay. Maybe that's something other planets don't have. Maybe they keep getting impacted by asteroids. Maybe volcanoes keep going off. Maybe there's a gas giant orbiting really close to the habitable planet's star, constantly disrupting the planet's environment and conditions, never allowing life to become complex at all. However, let's say that we do find evidence that complex life forms are in fact common in the universe, then maybe what's so rare is intelligent life. Humans have existed for a very short amount of time compared to other life forms. We've been here for around 200,000 years. Multicellular complex organisms, they've been here for around 500 million years. Basic single-celled organisms, they've been here for around 3.5 billion years. That's 25% the age of the universe. 200,000 years in it is nothing. However, let's say that we do find evidence that even intelligent life is common in the universe. Maybe what's so rare is intelligent life that becomes technologically developed. Sure, we've been here for 200,000 years, but how long have we been living this way, the way we live today? We've been inventing and discovering things since we've been here. We're smart, but a lot of our technological development happened in a very short amount of time. You could say the past 500 years or so. Beyond this point, if we find evidence that even intelligent life that becomes technologically developed is in fact common in the universe, this is the point where we get into some very disturbing possibilities. One of which is perhaps that alien civilizations, after inventing some kind of a technological thing, tend to annihilate themselves because of such a thing. Maybe it's nuclear weapons. We actually came close to annihilating ourselves a couple of times in our history, or at least doing some serious irreversible damage, such as that time. You know that as the Cuban Missile Crisis. If that had an outcome different than what the original outcome had, I might not be talking to you today. But let's say that alien civilizations that don't destroy themselves are in fact common in the universe. Maybe what's so rare are alien civilizations that are capable of communicating or traveling beyond their solar system. Why? Because the technology needed to do that is too expensive. Right now, more than 80% of our energy consumption comes from what is effectively stored star energy from the sun. Fossil fuels. The argument is that our consumption of fossil fuels at the peak is not going to be matched by other sources because fossil fuels are too cheap of an energy source. You don't have to put that much energy into them compared to the energy you can get out of them. And the technology needed in order to surpass that peak is itself too expensive, such as nuclear fusion. But let's say that alien civilizations that are capable of traveling or communicating beyond their solar systems is in fact something that is common in the universe. Maybe these alien civilizations deliberately choose not to contact Earth in order to avoid influencing its culture and its development, similar to the Prime Directive from Star Trek. That can be a possible reason. Maybe when these alien civilizations visit other planets, and these planets do have intelligent forms of life on them, the advanced alien civilization kills the inhabitants of the planet because, well, resources. Perhaps alien civilizations deliberately choose not to send out communication beyond their planet for exactly that reason. Perhaps all other alien civilizations are thinking the exact same way, creating a situation where no one is talking, even though they exist. Perhaps alien civilizations choose not to expand beyond their solar system, even though they are technologically capable of doing that, because they view it as wasteful and unnecessary. Depending on the solar system the alien civilization is currently in, they could be living for hundreds of billions of years if they found a way to create a self-sustained system. There's a lot of other possibilities besides the ones I mentioned. The scariest one of them all is perhaps that we are indeed alone in the universe. We just might become the species that I described at the beginning part of this video, the one that will invent a technology like warp drive and start expanding to a huge number of solar systems and galaxies. We just might choose not to communicate beyond Earth. We might just become just another intelligent species that will annihilate itself after we invent a particular technology. We just might choose to stay here on Earth for the next few billion years after we create a sustainable environment. It's not really clear what will happen. It will depend on the evidence that we will find in the future. It might be evidence we find, and it might be evidence that finds us. With all that said, what do you think? Are we alone? Thank you very much, and I will see you next time.